creations. If you're new to my channel and stopping by for the first time, thank you for stopping by. Welcome to my channel. Stick around a while by clicking that red button for more crafting on a budget, more everything on a budget videos to come. And if you click it again when the bell appears, YouTube will notify you when I'm uploading a new video. If you're interested in following me on social media, you can find those links in the description box below. So what do I have going on for you for today? Today I am bringing to you a DIY that is inspired by something that Allie saw on TV, and she asked me if I could recreate it for her room. And it's a DIY using this 18-inch wire wreath ring that you can get at Walmart for $287. This DIY is a pretty easy DIY, and I'd say it's pretty budget friendly, and there are two outcomes that can be made with this DIY, so I will be showing you both. I can't wait to show you what I do with this and what Allie wanted me to recreate for her room, so let's jump into it and let me show you what all you need for this DIY. For this DIY from Walmart, I picked up one of these 18-inch wire wreath rings for $287. This thick and chunky skein of yarn for $5. And from Michael's, I will be using this colored jute twine that I got for $2 a roll in their dollar bins. I'm using an 18-inch wire wreath form for this DIY because I wanted a bigger version of what I'm gonna be doing with this. This can very easily be done in any size. Now I'm gonna take the thick and chunky yarn by Mainstays. I picked this up in the color of Vanilla Dream. I'm gonna start off by hot gluing the end of my yarn to the back of the wire wreath form. I took and just cut a good amount of the yarn off of the skein because I found that when wrapping the wire wreath form with the yarn when it was connected to the skein, that it just was kind of a pain to do it. And so I figured I didn't mind doing this in sections, and so I cut a good amount to make it a bit easier to wrap this. And I'm gonna completely wrap this wire wreath form with this thick and chunky yarn. I chose this thick and chunky yarn because I knew that it would move the project a lot quicker wrapping this wire wreath form with this versus a thinner yarn. For a skein of this, it was $5, which isn't bad. I knew it wasn't gonna take the whole skein of yarn to wrap this. And so I thought, you know what? I like the look of this yarn. I love how fluffy and soft it looks. So I think that this is the perfect yarn to wrap this with. It took me maybe 5 minutes total to wrap this entire wreath form with this yarn. And after wrapping it, I still have half of the skein left. Now taking this colored twine that I picked up from Michael's, you get 25 yards for $2, which is a fantastic buy. I picked up this colored twine because it matches Allie's room. A great alternative is Dollar Tree's brown or green twine if you're going for a more rustic or farmhouse look for this DIY. I'm gonna start off with the pink twine, and I'm gonna hot glue it to the back of this wire wreath form. Then I'm randomly just gonna wrap it around the outside of this form just a few times. I'm not gonna do it too many times because I'm also gonna be using the green and the purple twine as well and wrapping it around this form. So once I've got what I'm happy with, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut off my color and hot glue it. And I'm gonna repeat this, like I said, with the purple and green twine as well. And you should be left with something that looks similar to this. And although this is not one of my farmhouse creations, it is a creation with this adorable twine, and so I felt like this DIY was in need of one of my twine flowers. If you haven't seen how I make my twine flowers, I have a full tutorial on that that I will link in the description box below for you, where I show you step by step how I make my twine flowers. And for the center of this flower, I'll be using just a pink button that I had on hand in my stash already. And I'm just gonna hot glue this to the yarn. Doesn't really matter where yet because there really is no top or bottom to this. And taking some of these medium-sized wood clothespins, again, these are clothespins that I had on hand already, that's why I'm using them. You can get a 50-pack of the mini clothespins at the Dollar Tree. Those would work just as well. And would you look at this? Isn't this just a stinking cute way to hang pictures? I think that this is just so stinking adorable. I can hardly stand it. And what a fun gift to give to somebody. So budget friendly, so inexpensive. And it's one of those things that you can do to suit anybody's decor. And for my alley girl, we're gonna go a step farther because she did not want this to be a picture holder. She wanted it to be a dream catcher. So that's what I'm doing now. And to make it a dream catcher, I need to make those pieces that hang down from the net itself. And so I'm gonna accordion fold my yarn at about 6 or 8 inches long, and I'm gonna attach it to another piece of yarn that's 18 inches long using my twine. And it's gonna kinda look like a tassel. That's what we're going for, is that tassel look and feel for those parts that hang down from the dream catcher. I don't really know what the proper name is. I just know that Allie saw something very similar to this. She asked me if I could do it in colors that would match her room, and so this is what we've come up with. Once I've got it attached with my twine, I'm gonna take my scissors and cut the loops because I want my tassel to be free. Then I'm gonna take some twine and I'm gonna hot glue it to the top of my yarn. And I'm just gonna wrap it around this yarn just to give it a bit of color and character so it ties into the top just a bit more. You should be left with something that looks like this. And to finish this bottom piece off, I thought I'd finish it off with a solid twine flower. And I'm just gonna hot glue it right to the center of where I use the twine to attach it. I made a total of what I'm gonna call tassels. 2 shorter ones and 1 longer one that I'm gonna attach to the bottom of this ring, centering the longest tassel in the middle and putting the 2 shorter ones on each side. Okay, this is so stinking cute. I love the outcome of this. Allie is so super excited. She loves how it turned out. She loves the colors. She loves having a giant size dream catcher in her room because it's something that definitely reminds her of her nana's. How fun is this piece? I love that there are 2 different outcomes that you can do with this, either as a picture hanger or a dream catcher. Allie saw it as a picture hanger and wanted it recreated, but she's been asking me for an oversized dream catcher forever, and so that was why we turned it into a dream catcher. This honestly, either way, is such a great gift to give, and it is so budget friendly, and I think that whoever it is that you're gifting this for, it is so easy to personalize it to suit their decor needs. I hope you all enjoyed today's video. Please give this video a thumbs up and let's get this video to 3,000 likes because those thumbs up, they really do help my channel to grow and it helps YouTube to notice me just a bit more. Until next time, everybody, I hope you have a fantastic day. Happy crafting on a budget and bye for now, everybody.